Welcome back again. In our previous video, we did 5 theorems which were based on circles. I strongly recommend you to watch the first video if you haven't seen it, because I have explained some basic concepts which are required for all the 12 theorems. Let's have a look at the statement of theorem number 6. Equal chords of a circle or of congruent circles are equidistant from the center. So I believe that just by looking at this statement, you must have recognized that this theorem also we will prove using properties of triangles, because usually when you have to prove some angle or some segment congruent, try to fit them in a triangle and prove that the triangles are congruent. So let's consider a circle with center O and two equal chords AB and CD. We have to prove that the distance from the center to the chord is equal. Let's call the distance as OE and OF. So if we can prove triangle AEO is equal to triangle CFO, then we can say that distance OE is equal to OF. AO is equal to CO because they are the radii of the same circle. We know AB is equal to CD because it's given. And according to the perpendicular bisector theorem, E and F are the midpoint. And hence, from this we can say that AE is equal to CF. Angle AEO is equal to angle CFO because both are 90 degrees. So from this we can say that both the triangles are now congruent by Arich's criteria of congruency. So from this we can say that OE is equal to OF. Here we are done with another theorem. Hope you all are understanding everything and trying to be with me. Let's have a look at the converse of the same theorem, which states that chords equidistant from the center of a circle are equal in length. Now we have to prove that the chords are equal. So if we can prove triangle AEO is equal to triangle CFO, we know that EO and FO are the perpendicular bisectors of the chords AB and CD respectively, which means half of AB is equals to AE and half of CD is equals to CF. So if we can prove that AE is equal to CF, we will be directly able to say that AB is equal to CD. So in triangle AEO and triangle CFO, AO is equal to CO because it's the radii of the same circle, EO is equal to FO because it's given, and angle AEO is equal to angle CFO because both are 90 degrees. Here again, both the triangles are congruent by Arich's criteria of congruency. So from this we can say that AE is equal to CF, and from this we can say that chord AB is equal to chord CD. I believe now, even before I start the theorem, you must be already having an idea that how we are going to prove it. Let's have a look at the next theorem. The angle subtended by an arc at the center is double the angle subtended by it at any point on the remaining part of the circle. I'm going to take this one a little slow and I want you to concentrate a little extra on this one. We have to prove that angle BAC is equal to half of angle BOC. This is a little tricky one, but it is not difficult. Here again we can see two triangles, but in here we are not going to prove them congruent. Let's have a look at the first triangle. Let's say triangle AOB. We can see that AO is equals to OB because both are the radii of the same circle. Now since these two sides of the triangle are equal, we know that their angles will also be equal. Hence we can say that angle BAO is equal to angle ABO. Now let's consider that angle BAO is equal to angle ABO is equal to X. Here we can see that angle BOD is nothing but the exterior angle of triangle AOB. And as I said in my introduction, using the exterior angle theorem, or also called as remote interior angle theorem, we can say that angle BOD is equal to angle BAO plus angle ABO, which is nothing but 2x. So from this we can say that angle BOD is equal to 2x. Similarly, in triangle AOC, we can say that angle CAO is equal to angle ACO, which is equals to y. Therefore, we are going to use exterior angle theorem again in here, and using that we can say that angle COD is equals to 2y. If we have a look at the diagram, we can see that angle BAC is nothing but x plus y, correct? And angle BOC is equals to angle BOD plus angle COD, which is nothing but 2x plus 2y, which is equals to twice of x plus y. So now from equation 3, we can say that angle BOC is equals to twice of angle BAC. And therefore, we can say that angle BAC is equal to half of angle BOC. If you found this one little difficult, do not worry. You can pause the video anytime and see it again till you understand and prove it on your own. Let's move to theorem number 9. Angles in the same segment of a circle are equal. This will be a lot easier because of the previous theorem that we just studied. If we take the same diagram of our previous theorem and we join BC, BAC is the major arc, and because of which BAC is the major segment and BC is the minor arc and minor segment. And we know that angle BAC is equal to half of angle BOC. Now, if you take point A anywhere else on the arc BAC, you will still find the same answer. Suppose we take a point F other than point A. Again, using our previous theorem, we can say that angle BFC is equal to half of angle BOC. So from this we can say that any number of angles which are in the same segment are equal. There's just one special case in here. Suppose that BC is passing through the center of the circle. In this case, the segment we have is a semicircle. We know angle BAC is equal to half of angle BOC. Therefore, we can say that BAC is equals to 90 degrees. Since BOC is nothing but the straight line here, and we know a line is of 180 degrees. So from this, we can conclude that angle subtended in a semicircle is a right angle. Here, we are done with in total 9 theorems out of 12, including our previous session. In our next session, we will complete the next 3 theorems and summarize all the 12 theorems in such a way that you will never forget them. Till then, if you like this video, do like it. And if you have any query, do comment. And don't forget to subscribe. Till then, keep watching, keep learning. Thank you.